Greetings, naturopath Eric Bakker from New Zealand, author of Candida Crusher, formulator of the Canxida range of dietary supplements. Here's a question I got asked recently from a gentleman in America. Can Nexium cause yeast infections? Well, these drugs, okay, there are different types of pharmaceutical medications that are designed by pharmaceutical companies to reduce stomach acidity, proton pump inhibitors and H2 antagonists, so different types. So I believe that I'm not quite sure if Nexium is the H2 antagonist. I think it is a H2 antagonist, or it could also be a proton pump inhibitor. So there are many different kinds of drugs in both of these classes. You know, you've got, I think, Prevacid, you've got Tagamet, you've got Zantac, you've got Gaviscon, you've got Nexium. So these are all funny names we give to drugs that are designed to block acidity in the stomach by different kinds of mechanisms. Research in the States recently found that 71% of people who take these drugs, in fact, have a yeast infection. And in 2010, warnings were starting to be placed on some of these products showing that osteoporosis is actually linked with a lot of these medications because it blocks the uptake of calcium. 2012, the FDA required manufacturers to list that magnesium deficiency is a reality as well. And in 2013, the American Medical Association started to say that B12 deficiencies can occur with these kinds of drugs. But what they're not telling you also is that you've got a higher risk of cancer, and you've got a higher risk of deficiencies of folate, iodine, zinc, and many other minerals and trace elements that can lead to very, very poor health. So Dr. Jonathan Wright, still practicing today, quite a well-known doctor from Seattle, quite a remarkable guy. I heard Dr. Wright speak in Seattle in 2003. I went to his four-day nutritional conference. It was remarkable, and along with Dr. Alan Gaby. So Dr. Wright has long been a proponent of recommending people to do what we call the Heidelberg test. It's a capsule you can swallow that determines your level of acidity in the stomach. Many people who have heartburn and reflux, in fact, have under-acidity rather than over-acidity. And if you have got an under-acidity, you're more prone to getting a Helicobacter pylori infection or a yeast infection. You're also more prone to getting SIBO or small intestinal bacterial overgrowth. And you're certainly more prone to a lot of different nutritional deficiencies. So the stomach's aim really is to help to break food down to a liquid called chyme and to increase the efficiency and digestion of this mixture, you know, extract the nutrients out of it once it gets into the duodenum, or what we call the duodenum, this part of the world. You also need a good low pH of the stomach to convert the enzymes that the pancreas produces to the active form. So the pancreas produces proenzymes. Now, they can't be active when they're made or they digest the pancreas. So having a low pH stomach and a good acidity level will ensure a good production of active pancreatic enzymes. So many people experience pancreatic problems. I see they have sort of pain here around the sternum and, you know, feeling full after meals or a lump in the stomach, and that can often be a pancreatic problem. So the question was, can Nexium cause a yeast infection? Well, it's certainly linked with yeast infection, and you've got a much higher probability of getting a serious yeast infection when you stay on this drug and of poor health in general. Nexium is a $6.4 billion industry last year alone in the States. It's big money. So if you're taking Nexium, you may want to be careful with this drug long term because it could well be linked with yeast infection. Don't forget to do my online quiz at yeastinfection.org if you're taking any kind of pharmaceutical drug, because it'd be good for you to know whether you've got mild, moderate or severe candida. You can also read my book, Candida Crusher, at candidacrusher.com. And you can also check out my product range at canxida.com, which may help you out there as well. So thanks for tuning in.